Hi, my name is Stefan Mencias, president of the Texas Mars Robotics team here at the University of Texas at Arlington. Since last season, we have continuously been improving our rover by reducing the weight and increasing the dexterity and modularity of the rover.
This year, our rover has made some big changes to its design. Most significant change by far is an added link near the wrist. Instead of actuating around the same axis as the first link, it rotates around the axis perpendicular to that axis, giving us horizontal motion without rotating the shoulder. The second major change is in the gripper design. Last year, our gripper did not provide optimal angle for tests that require fine motor adjustments. With parallel pads, we were able to grip objects firmer and more accurately than before.
The circuit box for all the electronics on board will see a large reduction in size and weight. Along with this, the aluminum tubing used for this year's frame will see a 50% reduction in weight while still providing the same basic floor mat for components. The motor and gearbox combination will see a hefty improvement as well. The motor and gearbox combination is custom built for our needs this year. This not only improves the necessary torque and speed requirements, but it also allows us to ensure a longer lifetime of the motors with less required maintenance. A leg mount consisting of double-layered thermoplastic polyurethane material, or TPU, will be used to dampen vibrations throughout the body. This also allows for proper operation of the electronics on board, as well as a more stable camera image while the rover is on the move. To further stabilize the electronics on board, the circuit box will be mounted onto dampers.
This year, instead of starting from scratch on our design, we made our original design more streamlined, more compact, and more efficient. We started by shortening the entire module by 4.5 inches, losing 5 pounds of weight in the process. It still performs the same functions, and with less length, there is less room for torsion and vibrations while drilling. Our system has the capability to drill to the desired depth of 10 centimeters, test the temperature and moisture of that soil, and then test it for nitrates or phosphorus, depending on what the science team feels will give them the best indication of proof of life. All of this happens on board, observed by a camera that relays video back to the base station. In previous years, we struggled to keep the electronics modular and easy to access. This year, all of that has changed. We have added quick disconnect pins that go to an entirely modular box that contains the Arduino, motor shields, and other control boards. This allows the controls team to detach the electronics entirely to be worked on separately should anything need to be fixed or changed.
Our team proposes that life on Mars may be identified by analyzing soil samples for bacterial endospores. In times of extreme stress, bacterium can produce endospores, a dormant and highly resistant cell, which can survive desiccation, high temperature, high irradiation, and remain viable for thousands of years. We will be using the Schaefer-Fulton method staining technique to distinguish between vegetative cells and endospores. A primary stain using malachite green will be used to stain the endospores. Previously, our team attempted to identify life through the sequencing of nucleic acids. This year, our team opted for a less complicated and more economical testing technique.
Other improvements this year are in the areas of vehicle safety and power management. For vehicle safety, we are monitoring the slope of the terrain and using that slope data to control the power to the rover's drive systems, as well as determine if the slope of the terrain exceeds our operating parameters. We are also monitoring the rover's surroundings via an array of ultrasonic sensors and using that data to help the rover navigate around obstacles that are too big for it to drive over. For power management, we have implemented a remote shutdown function if it is determined that there is a serious enough issue to warrant it.
Since last year's performance during the autonomy section, we have learned a lot. We have created several upgrades and improvements which improve the accuracy of the navigation system. We have also improved our tracking system, which can detect tennis balls from around 20 feet away. Our other improvements include a brand new user interface, which helps us to enhance and visualize the surrounding area. The new interface includes a 3D visual that displays the feedback received from the arm and various other subcomponents.